the Twilight Council about to finish up. Most likely it's going to be for Blink. Hitman does seem to favour this style. Now in comes the Reaper, focusing down the shields of the Stalker, and some nice micro there from Hitman. Does focus down the weaker one, and Sanju is retreating away. Of course there are four Reapers coming behind this, so he's going to have more to deal with shortly, but he is going for that, well, he's going for Blink. So once the Blink Stalkers get into play, he's going to be very, very effective at shutting this down. The question is, can he survive and not take any eco damage? So, I'm just checking actually. One second. There we go. Anyway, guys, so he goes with the set of Reapers. Mothershore is going to try and handle this, with the Reapers focusing down that Stalker, pulling some probes off the line. Second Stalker now coming into play, does focus it down. Probe's doing a nice job to tank and shoo them away right now. He's got half of the mining. The gateways are almost finished. He just needs to buy himself a little bit more time. That Mothership Core also is building up for that photon overcharge. Needs another 10 seconds before, of course, it can actually get that one out. But the gateways are finished, so he's going to have more Stalkers as well. He's got two more Stalkers here. Mothership Core sitting over these Reapers to try and do some damage. But in come the Reapers. They're trying to do as much damage as they possibly can, but four Stalkers are warped in just in the nick of time, and there we go. He does push this back, and now Sanju has a bit of a situation on his hands, because obviously Blink Stalkers are very, very good at dealing with Reapers, because Reapers only do light damage, and they don't even do that great amount of light damage anymore. Fourth gateway is coming down, so this is going to be four gate. Blink as well, pushing on in. We have bunkers coming down, but there's no marauders here to be seen, and it's just going to be pure Reaper versus Blink Stalker right now. Blinks away, there we go. Four pylon is now being put on down, and yeah, I say Blink Stalkers versus Reapers right now. In come nice focus fire there actually from Sandru, but even better blinks back from Hitman, and he's just just chewing away on top of these Reapers right now, killing off this reactor, focusing down the bunker. Bunker does get up, Reapers are sitting inside, but of course he can just sit here and shoot this back all day long. I'm forcing the lift there actually, focusing down the supply depots as well. More Blink Stalkers are coming into the fray right now, and there we go, focusing down the first bunker. No repairs going on it. Reapers are exposed. There goes down one Reaper. Now focusing down the second bunker. SCV is trying to be pulled, but a little bit late then. Now the SCVs are having to join in the frame. We've got Reapers and SCVs versus Blink Stalkers. Hitman having to retreat just for a moment now, but he's looking very, very strong in this situation. He's got the stronger, more healthier Stalkers at the front, the weaker ones at the back, and here we go, in he comes. He sees the two bunkers in repair, and are we going to see the big aggressive Blink? No, he's just blinking the back one at a time, carefully. Very nice control here, and now there's more Stalkers and Reapers here, and this is just not looking good from Sanju, and we see the well played. So that means it's 3-0 for Hitman right now. Eternal Dreamers currently steamrolling through this best of seven right now. Can anyone knock Hitman off his throne? We are about to find out. So guys, stay tuned. I'm just going to have a quick break and a quick drink, and then we'll be back for game number four. And then I have another set of games from the SCA Ascension Team League. So stay tuned, and hope you're enjoying the show. Okay, guys, I'm back for our next game of our series. We have our two teams. It is O Gaming versus Eternal Dreamers, and then I have the pleasure of bringing you SCA versus FLC. Again, two big North American teams. SCA, who are very, very heavy in the Grandmaster front, so we will see some definitely very, very cool games from them. Again, thank you for all your positive feedback in the chat. And yeah, just some comments just sort of going around. So I couldn't agree more. They say that SD lost the first Reaper. Yeah, it did. It kind of just compounded, and the sort of Blinkstalkers versus Reapers is always asking for trouble there. But yeah, FLC indeed. So if you are any FLC fans out there, let me know. Show me that you're here watching. And as a, if you just tuned in, I'm Dom. I'm from Poison TV. Yada yada yada. And I will be about, I will be out about quite a bit. You can check me out tomorrow in Steel Series. I will be. Oh, call them to servo. Well, there we go. So you may. Yeah, you will. I will try and bring you the best cast. I keep forgetting, of course, I'm not used to this fact that there's no delay. I'm kind of on my own tether. I can actually speak to my audience, which I quite like, because not very often casters get to interact with people, because we have constraints like delay, which we have to respect and so on. So bringing on our next game, let's jump in. It's Hitman on an absolute carnage spree right now. It is game number four. It is Tenza versus Hitman, and let's watch what happened with him. So Frost, one of the new maps from the ladder pool, and we are going to jump on in. Okay, here we are with our next map. Let's fire up all our tabs and dials so everyone gets some good information, some feedback, some content. They get to feel the experience with me as the caster, and it is none other in the orange shorts playing for O Gaming, their last and final hope in this best of seven. It is Tenza. And of course, playing for Eternal. Well, Eternal Dreamers, we know him, we love him, we've seen all his shenanigans so far, or have we? It is none other than Hitman. And look at this, Hitman, looking like he might be actually going for a gateway expand. So, again, this map Frost. Yeah, I've heard mixed reviews about it. Tell me what you think of this map so far. Tell me about your ladder experiences. The general feeling I get right now is that thirds and fourths, there seems to be a little bit of a kind of argument which fourth or which third to go for. Some people preferring to go for this third here, and some people actually opting to go for this third here and then destroying the rocks. Zergs, I've seen Zanster, for example, who plays Fnatic, he likes to take the third here. He creates a creep canal with the four queen opening, and then that allows him to reinforce his third a lot better, because obviously there's quite a distance here to this third. You can obviously make good use of this high ground here. Alternatively, some people are quite comfortable, they don't mind, they wall off the bridge here and then they play out the game that way. So excuse me there. We do see pull coming down, 15 pull, and Hitman's going to go in with the probe scout, and we see one gas as well for Hitman as well. So at the moment, kind of suggests one gate FB might see a 17 gas Avalanche cybernetic score, but who knows. Now this opening, for all those on the ladder, if you do go gateway expand, very good, especially if your Zerg is going for some sort of 10 pull speed, you know, your 14 pull, 14 speed kind of opening. Then they drop the hatch, they build some lings, they deny your pylons, and it can be a real nuisance, especially if they get into your base. So just by simply creating some sim city, you can actually prevent that. So yep, here we go, we have the gas now coming down, which is kind of a traditional with the gateway expand, because what happens is you need that early speed, because obviously you're going to be facing aggression a lot earlier, so gas allows you to tech a lot earlier. You can get the Roach Warren actually on two bases, you can go for that Lenox style where you get two evos and you go for 1-1. You've got a whole host of options. You can drop a Baneling Nest, you can put on some aggression with the gas. Some people like to do the three hatch with before pull as an alternative option, and some people actually just go for the traditional fast third. But obviously with the four gate pressure after dropping the expo, we end up with you can end up losing your third with some pressure. Anyway, speaking of four gates, there is no expo, but there is four gates here, and Hitman is looking to end this very, very quickly, and yeah, four gates still works. It's still a build you have to respect and learn. Kind of, it's almost become like one of those kind of not taboo builds. What's the best way to explain it? But you know, it's like one of those like, oh, like two gates and cannon rushes. It's always a bit cheesy, but they do kill you. Like, you know, if you don't know how to defend it, they do kill you. But we do have Tenzin with a lot of Zerglings here. He's dropping the Spine Crawler down. He's going to get that speed, which is going to be oh so handy at shutting this down. And so far, he's doing a fantastic job chewing down on this Stalker. We do have four pylons, though, and the Chrono Boost is coming out on top of these gateways. Shuts down that forward pylon there. Spine Crawler's up. He's got Queens at the front, and he's looking in fantastic shape to hold this. We've got 14 more Zerglings on the way, actually. A lot of Stalkers as well. Speed is not quite finished though, and here we go, just kiting in and out, focusing down these two queens. Gets one queen, gets us, no, doesn't get the second queen, looking to snipe there, just poking away right now. And now the forward pylon is coming up. We have a few more zealots joining the fray. A lot of zerglings here, focusing down on that spine crawler, trying to get us around there. Zealots are coming in, just slowly ticking away. The speed is almost finished right now, and here we go, speed now finished, is going to poke in. Now we go for going for that big surround. More zealots warping on in, some nice stalker micro. Is he going to be able to shut this down? Looks like Hitman will actually clear up these zerglings, surprisingly. We zoom on out to see have a look at some of this action, and wow, good surround here from our opponent Tenza. And Hitman, wow, he's clearing up those zerglings as well. Actually, always seems like he's actually going to surround and kill him, but these positioning with like the stalkers and zealots, the way he's like hold positioning the zealots in front of the stalkers, he's actually doing a fantastic job. And we have a look at the drone count right now. It's currently 18 to 20. So actually, Hitman's got the worker advantage. He's got another round of zergling coming on in, but he's in a position right now where he can just chew away on this hatchery, and slowly but surely, Tenza is going to have to make a move sooner or later. He's looking to kill off those... actually, is he going to do a run by? I think he is going to. We're going to see some sort of base trade scenario, actually. He's looking to actually put pressure on back at home, get into that mineral line. But anyway, Hitman is going to kill this natural, killing off. There we go, that natural does drop on down. He has now had free reign in the main. We've got a spine crawler as well. More spine crawlers coming in. He's going to try and hold on for his last. Well, it's one last ditch effort, but behind this we have a pylon. Hitman has walled off his ramp, and there are so many units, and Tenza with the GG means that Hitman takes this 4-0. So yeah, Eternal Dreamers versus OGaming this week, I say, well, for this round anyway, we have an all kill. So well played to Hitman, and I can tell you from yesterday's games as well, Hitman all killed the team there as well, so he's on an absolute monster spree right now. I don't know what you call like a double kill, is it like a monster kill or something? He's like taking 8 opponents down. He's currently 8-0 in the SEA.